Hello dear friends and students, welcome back to the new session. Have come with our new topic in this video lecture. It is syllabification or a division of syllables in a word. So we are going to learn through this video what is a syllable, how do syllables divide in a word, what are the types of syllables, and what is the structure of a syllable is also going to be discussed through this video. Are you ready to learn what is a syllable and other details related to the syllable? Yeah, I think you are ready. Okay, let us move on to the discussing with few examples first. Later we'll define what is a syllable. Okay, let us try to understand first what is a syllable. If you understand, you can also define yourself what is a syllable first. So let me try to explain what is a syllable through the examples listed on the screen. Right, the first word is cat, access, grammar, pleasure, donate, monkey, elephant, elephant, university. So here you can see here these are the phonetic transcriptions of the words. So actually, if you would like to learn the syllabification, one must need the knowledge of phonetics. Phonetics means which is a separate alphabet is created to get a correct pronunciation, which is called IPA, International Phonetic Alphabet. Okay, they are in 44 symbols. Okay, they are also divided into vowels and consonants. I am not going to discuss this 44 symbols in detail, but with the help of transcriptions I am trying to let you know what is a syllable and how it is going to be divided in a word. Okay, right, so here is the word, the cat. You can see produced in one breathe sound, cat. You do not get any break in the production of sound. So here we have consonant, vowel and consonant. Here we have three symbols combined into one sound, cat. Okay, right, so here one symbol is, especially this one, it is looking like a small X letter, right? So this is actually a symbol of vowel which produces the sound of a. So here this is in red color, right? Now you can see this is a vowel sound, a, so cat. Entire the three sounds produce, three letters produce one sound, cat, right? So here we have only one vowel sound, so the word has one syllable. What does it mean? If a word has one vowel sound, means the word is a monosyllabic word. Now let us look into the second word, access. Now you can see here the first symbol, again this repeated a, right? The word started with a, it's a vowel sound, and k, s, a, s. Again we have five sounds. We have 1, 2, 3 consonant sounds and 1, 2, 2 vowel sounds we have. So here the word has two breathing sounds. For example, access, 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 access. So this is the call. Okay, so here again for a simplified classification based on vowel sounds, so the word has two vowel sounds, so the word has two syllables, right? So it can be called disyllabic word. Again, let us take the word grammar. Again, gra, gra, ma, grammar. So if a sound which is produced in a bracket, that means it is silent. Okay. So grammar. So here again a, again we produced and a. So two vowel sounds. So the word grammar also has two syllables. So it is also disyllabic word. And next one, pleasure. Okay, play a jure. So here again we have two vowel sounds, so it is also two syllabic word. And next one, donate. Here four symbols are in red color. Okay, four are in red color, but here these two sounds are going to be considered this is going to be considered as one vowel sound only. It is called a diphthong. A diphthong has two symbols to represent one or to produce one sound. Okay, to produce one sound. So here this is a o, ow. So donate. Okay, so how it is produced, so it is one sound, so one vowel. And next one, eight. So night it is produced, a. This is a diphthong. So we have two diphthongs. So diphthongs also called vowels. Okay, so again the word donate also have two syllables. Monkey. Again we have two sounds which are going to be considered two syllable words. So the word elephant, here elephant. So here we have two vowel sounds, so the word has three syllables, so it is going to be called as trisyllabic word. And next word and last word, university. So here you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 consonant sounds, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 vowel sounds we have. University. Okay, so here 5 vowel sounds we have. So if a word consists more than 3 vowel sounds, that word is called polysyllabic word. Okay, so if the word has 3, like an elephant, that is called trisyllabic word. If the word has 2 syllables, that is called disyllabic. If the word has 1 syllable, that is called monosyllabic word. And this is the thing you need to identify. So what we are going to understand through these examples, if you know the transcription of the word, you will easily identify the vowel sounds in a given word. So if you find one syllable, one vowel sound, so it has one syllable. If the word has two vowel sounds, then it is going to be two syllabic word. If the word has three vowel sounds, then it is going to be trisyllabic word. If the word has more than three, then it is going to be polysyllabic word, it is going to be considered. So this is the point you need to understand here. So this is clearly mentioned. So monosyllable means a word that consists of a single syllable. Disyllable, a word of two syllables. Trisyllable, a word of three syllables. Polysyllable, a word of more than three syllables. So this is the classification of syllables you can see. So monosyllable, disyllable, trisyllable and polysyllable. Now let us look at the structure of a syllable, right? So the sigma is going to be used as a symbol of a syllable. So here you can see this sigma as a symbol of a syllable. So a syllable can be divided into two categories. One is onset and another one is rhyme. So again, rhyme is subdivided into two categories, nucleus and coda. right? So this is the structure of a syllable, right? So syllable is going to be divided into two parts, onset, rhymer, and rhyme and nucleus and coda. So this is the structure of the syllable. Let us discuss this same structure with an example. The word axis I have taken here. So the word axis has two syllables. So axis, right? So let us observe the first syllable, how it is divided. So the word, the first syllable has two sounds here we have, right? So the first one is ak and second one is k. So the syllable started with a nucleus, or nucleus means vowel sound. Nucleus means vowel sound, and onset means consonant sound. Coda means consonant sound. Onset means consonant sound. Nucleus means vowel sound. Okay, right. This is very important. Now, the vowel itself can make a syllable, but a consonant cannot make itself a syllable. Consonant always associate with a vowel sound, then a syllable can be possible. But a vowel independently can produce a syllable, it is. So we will discuss the some more example later. Let me tell you the structure of this, the first syllable of axis, ak. Now you can see ak, you can write here, and then onset. Here onset means consonant sound. Is it started with a consonant sound? There is no consonant sound. So then it is no onset it has. Now what rhyme? So rhyme is divided into two parts, nucleus and coda. So what does it mean, nucleus? Vowel sound. So a is a vowel sound and we have taken as a nucleus. And next, k. So k is a consonant sound. Coda means consonant sound. So here it is k. So here is the structure is no onset, nucleus and coda. So here it is two symbols producing the sound, one syllable, that is called ak. Is that clear? Now let us see the second syllable of the word axis. So ses, here is s, s, a, s. These are the three sounds produced the second syllable of the word axis. Now here you can write a syllable and onset. This is the first sound of the syllable s. It is taken as onset. It is a consonant sound. And the second sound a, it is taken as a nucleus because it is a vowel sound. Again, s is also consonant sound, which is taken as coda. So the second syllable in the word axis has onset, nucleus and coda. So this is the way you can understand. Nucleus is very important. Without a nucleus, a syllable is not going to be constructed. Okay, but a nucleus itself can produce a syllable. Okay, you will see. Okay, if you, for example, a consonant after nucleus is called coda, a consonant before nucleus is called onset. Remember, a consonant before nucleus is called onset. A consonant after nucleus is called coda. This is the thing you need to remember. So a syllable can start with onset or without onset, or it can start a nucleus or it cannot be nucleus. So we need to identify. Okay, let us see this aspects in detail. Okay, so now we understood now what is a syllable. So a syllable has one or more sounds uttered in one breath pulse. In one breath pulse we are going to produce. So a syllable has one or more sounds uttered, in one breath pulse. For example, the word cat, three sounds produced in one breath pulse, right? For example, access, ak, two symbols, two sounds produced in one syllable. In the second syllable, three, s, a, s. These three sounds produced one breath pulse. So this is called, okay? So a syllable necessarily has at least one vowel sound. It must have, a syllable must have one vowel sound. This vowel sound is going to be called as nucleus. This is going to be called as nucleus. Okay? So, a syllable may have none, one, or more consonants before and after the nucleus. I already explained that point. Okay? Even look at this, some more examples you can see here. The word I. Here, the word I is, you can see, produced with only the nucleus, only the vowel sound, diphthong, I, only the diphthong. It does not have onset or coda, but it is produced as syllable, right? So this is called a monosyllabic word, you can call it. So a vowel sound can only produce the syllable. So without vowel sound, there is no possibility of production of syllable, it is. So consonant itself cannot produce a syllable. So syllable must need vowel sound. This vowel sound is called nucleus. Now you can see here. Now the second word, in. Again, the word in does not have onset. It started with the nucleus and ended with the coda, right? So this is, so no onset. Now let us take the third word, print. Here we can see this is p is a consonant, r is a consonant, e is a vowel, n is a consonant, t is a consonant. So here we have two consonants and four consonants. A vowel is located between two consonants. Here we can see, okay, cc, vcc. Here we have. So here we can find p, r is a onset, e is a nucleus, n, t is coda. So here this is the point you can understand very clearly. So the word print has onset, nucleus and coda, right? So we can understand a syllable is equivalent to what is called akshar in many Indian languages. And they, let me talk in Telugu here. Syllable anedi mana Telugu bhashalo oka aksharam tho samanam, right? Okay, mana aksharalanu achuluga halluluga manam vibhajinchukunnamu alagane vaatiki talakattu deergalu tarvata ottulu గుణింతాలుగా మనం విభజించుకొని ఇలా ఈ యొక్క ప్యాటర్న్తోని మనము కావలసిన ఒక సౌండ్ని మనం ప్రొడ్యూస్ చేసుకుంటాం. అయితే ఇక్కడ ఇంగ్లీష్ భాగానికి వచ్చినప్పుడు మనకు ఉన్న 26 లెటర్స్తోని వీఆర్ అనేబుల్ టు ప్రొడ్యూస్ ఆల్ ద సౌండ్స్. వన్ లెటర్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు ప్రొడ్యూస్ మల్టిపుల్ సౌండ్స్. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ టేక్ లెటర్ సి, ఇట్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు ప్రొడ్యూస్ స సౌండ్, క సౌండ్, అగైన్ cha sound it is going to, for example, chair. In the word chair, it is produced the cha sound. For example, in the word cat, the cis letter produced the ka sound. And for example, since, in the word since, cis produced the sound of sa. So this is the problem has with English language. That's why the phoneticians have invented the IPA. IPA means International Phonetic Alphabet. And that alphabet is going to be help to know the correct pronunciation of each word, okay? So based on that knowledge, the transcription, we can divide the syllables in a word. So here the syllable is equivalent to what is called aksharam. Mana bhashalo oka aksharaniki samanamainadi syllable ani ardham, okay na? So prati oka aksharamu okoka sound ni produce chestundi. Kani English question tarvata letters anetivi okoka letter okoka sound ni produce cheyavu. Avi phonemes, 44 phonemes are going to produce each symbol one sound. So diphthongs again two syllables and one sound it is going to be. So we have to consider syllable as an aksharam in our language so that you can understand in clear more. Okay. Now usually a single consonant between two vowels between two vowels is the onset of the following syllable, right? So syllable is the highest unit in phonology. All speech sounds are gathered in syllables. So in most of the dictionaries, syllables are separated by placing a hyphen in orthography. Orthography means in the form of spelling, and by placing a dot between them in phonetic transcription. So these are this is the good information related to the syllabification. I hope you understand. If you have any doubt, please let me know through comment section. Thank you.